is the cash conversion cycle. Again, something we'll talk about, we've already talked about a little bit and why it's so important, but we'll talk about this again here on a preliminary basis. Huge, massive jump since 2007 from 216 days. Let me make note of this. 216 days. And I make notes of everything I do so I don't have to rely on my memory in the past or in the future when I'm trying to make my analysis solid. I don't want to rely on any guessing. I want to rely on hard facts and what I was thinking as I was researching the company to 600.3 days. 600.3 days in the trailing 12. Or a rise of 600.3 minus 216 divided by 600.3. 64%. That is scary. 64%. That means the cash conversion cycle means, and we've already talked about this a little bit, but it's such an important concept. That I'm going to go over everything kind of we talked about again, and hopefully it'll begin to make more sense the more you learn about it and with future trainings as well. This number is one of the most important numbers I look at on a preliminary basis, like we talked about the other day. Why? Because this one number I can tell from comparing this number to this number. Or even in most cases, go back 5 years, but this one's such a huge jump, more than almost tripled in let's see, a 7 year time period, 10 year time period, almost tripled. This means going from this number to this number almost tripling in 10 years means that the company is having a harder time selling its products, which means it's having a longer, or it's taking longer for them to get paid. This is the amount of days this entire cycle takes. Right here. These three things. Damn it. These three are what goes into the cash conversion cycle. Again, we talked about this the other day, but I want to reiterate what everything means. Days sales outstanding means how long something takes to sell. Days inventory is how much inventory the company has. And how long that inventory has been taking to sell. And the payables period is how long it takes them to pay their suppliers. So, here, another. Normally, I just look at this metric, the cash conversion cycle as a whole. But in this, I can spot another problem. Payables period. They're paying their suppliers in an average of 31 days. But it's taking them 116 days to sell their products. And their inventory is sitting there for 515 days. This is a massive, massive, massive problem. The longer it takes a company to sell its products, the longer it takes them to get cash for it to buy future products, and the longer it takes them to pay their suppliers eventually. This could lead to several problems, some of which could be problems with their suppliers. Maybe their suppliers are getting tired of getting paid later. In this case, it's not a huge jump, but at some point, if they continue to not sell their inventory, they're either not going to buy from the supplier anymore, or they're going to have to start pushing out their payment period longer, which suppliers don't like. The longer it takes them to sell products, the longer it takes them to build cash, to build future products, to put in R&D, capital expenditures, stuff like that. And one of the most important problems is the day's inventory. I can tell from this number. Let's go to the balance sheet. Normally, I wouldn't go to the balance sheet yet, but I want to talk about this again. The balance sheet. Go to the income or go to financials. Income statement usually pop are always popped up first, and then go to the balance sheet. I always look at the quarterly to get the most recent information. Inventories. So those have risen, but. Let's go back and look at the inventories. Their inventories have risen by about was that 7 million? 7 million Singaporean dollars in 5 years. When inventories rise while sales fall, and it takes longer for the company to sell their products, it leads to massive problems, some of which I've already talked about, but the biggest one is, or the biggest potential one, is that the company may have to write down their inventories at some point. This would lead to a reduction in balance sheet book value, a reduction in value of the entire company, since value investors most of the time go by balance sheet first, at least on a preliminary basis, on evaluation. This would lower the company's NCAV, Ben Graham, NCAV valuation, tangible book valuation if they had to write down inventories. And again, normally I wouldn't know this because this would be a preliminary analysis, but since I've looked at the financials, they have begun writing down some of their inventories. So again, this is why the cash conversion cycle is such a major, major important thing I look at during any preliminary analysis of any company. Of course, this number is more important for companies like manufacturers, retailers, companies with hard assets, they sell stuff like that. And it can also be negative, like we talked about, like a Walmart or Amazon. Their cash conversion cycle, I haven't checked in a while, but last time I did check, they were both negative, which is fantastic. They're getting their products, selling them, and paying their suppliers before they have to pay their suppliers. So essentially, the customers are paying for the products before they even have them in hand and have to buy them. Fantastic problem. It's not a fantastic problem. It's a fantastic thing when that happens because you don't have to push out sales. You don't have to wait for cash flow to come in. That's why Walmart and one of the reasons Walmart and Amazon are so fantastic, such fantastic businesses, is because they turn their inventory so fast. That can lead to competitive advantages, economies of scale. And that's one of the major advantages Amazon and Walmart has, is while they might not make the biggest margin on each sale, they can offer their customers lower prices, get them their products faster, and make smaller margins, but on a much higher volume of products. This keeps competition out and leads to a bunch of other great things happening. So again, this is why the cash conversion cycle is so important, and why we spent so much time talking about it in our training sessions, and why I'll continue to talk about it every time it comes up. But for now